Three.
Hello, everyone. Good morning and a warm welcome to Microsoft APAC's AI for Accessibility Hackathon 2020. This is an annual event, and this year, as you can see, we are making it all virtual so that we can work with you across all countries. So thank you. Thank you for joining us on this journey. Developers, startups, our partners, all of us are going together to actually use our power of technology to innovate. I'm Pratima Amunkar. I lead cloud solution partners with the One Commercial Partner Organization of Microsoft. And I'm also the accessibility chair for APAC locally and globally. So once again, welcome to all of you to this launch event. We have closed captioning and transcription for the event, which is readily available. So please do sit back for the next half an hour and join us as we are welcoming you onto this whole journey, as we say, about being innovators in accessibility. Join us on the journey to make our world more inclusive. How we look at it is that there are no limits to what people can achieve when technology truly reflects the diversity of everyone who uses it. What exactly is accessibility? When we work in this space, many people come and ask us this question about, what do you look at? What is accessibility all about? I typically respond in a single sentence. It's really about creating experiences that are better for everyone. It's about enabling people to achieve whatever it is that they want to achieve. And that's where AI comes in. That's the power of AI. AI has the ability to change what's possible for people with disabilities. AI can add a layer of personalization for all of us. And I found it so powerful when somebody told me that if in the past you had to adapt to the world around you, in the future, with the power of AI, the world will adapt to you, to your preferences. And how does this really, impact us on a day-to-day basis? What are we trying to aim at where accessibility is concerned? We aim to build technologies that empower everyone across the whole spectrum of disabilities to unlock their potential when at work, at school, or in their daily lives. And what's driving us in this space? Did you know that there are over 1 billion people in this world who have disabilities? Many of them have the need for assistive technology. But did you know that only 1 in 10 have access to the products that they need? And this means that most people cannot fully participate in our economies or our societies. And accessible technology can allow us to fully participate, every one of us. Another important piece is the fact that only, a whole bunch of disabilities are not visible to us. So 70% of disability is invisible. So you may not always know what could be a challenge for those around you. And finally, remember that disability can be permanent, it can be situational, it can hit any of us or someone that we love at any point of time. So it's really that we need to look at accessibility as something that is a responsibility for us. It has now become core to our mission to empower individuals and organizations on the planet to achieve more. We are super passionate about creating products and services that are truly accessible to everyone. To demonstrate what this really means, I would like to run a short video. So over to you, please. Please run the video.
My name is Grover.
Sean.
My name is Ian.
I'm Taylor.
My name is Owen, and I am 9 and a half years old.
So Owen was born with a rare genetic disorder called Escobar syndrome.
He's had 33 surgeries to date.
I love video games, my friends, my family, and again, video games.
It's his way of interacting with his friends when he can't physically otherwise do it.
What I like about the adaptive controller is now everyone can play. You can just say, all right, that's that button, that's that button, that's that button. Perfect.
One of the biggest fears early on is, how will Owen be viewed by the other kids?
He's not different when he plays.
No matter how your body is or how fast you are, you can play. It's a really good thing to have in this world.
Pratima.
So thank you. Thank you for the video very much. And you know, what I'd like for all of us to sit down and think about is what's next. In the next 25 years, technology has the power to empower and change opportunities for people with disabilities. Innovations designed by and with people with disabilities will basically create greater experiences for everyone. And this culture of accessibility, when you know you couple it with technology, that's when breakthrough innovations are possible. And I and all of us in Microsoft firmly believe that AI is what is going to be the amplification, the tool to be able to accelerate this innovation, the tool that will open up doors to new waves of possibilities. And we believe strongly that AI can amplify human capability and that it will improve, truly improve the way people with disabilities interact and leverage technology in their daily lives. It's because of this that we had launched the AI for Accessibility, a program aimed at leveraging the power of AI to create new assistive technology. And last year, we launched the AI for Accessibility Hackathon here at APAC to help really harness the creative energy that is there with our partners, with developers who are coding on our stack, as well as the startups that we work closely with to make the tech work for people with disabilities. To make it real for you, let me share with you a huge success story. I'm so excited to invite the winners of last year's challenge at Singapore, Zopa.ai, who have a great story to share with you about how they worked with us on the hackathon and then their journey in the past few months post the hackathon. So over to you, please run the video.
Microsoft Asia Pacific announced the hackathon for AI for accessibility. Our partner development manager, Garima and Pratima, highly encouraged us to participate in the hackathon. The hackathon was for a solution to improve employability for people with autism. We felt strongly about the cause, but were unsure if it would lead to something concrete other than the fact it was a good initiative and that we did not want to say no to. We went ahead in the spirit of the idea upon Microsoft's encouragement. Our team did a great job in putting together a solution of an artificial intelligence-enabled virtual mentor for employers to help them hire and manage people with autism spectrum disorder, as well as a mentor for people with autism to support them digitally through their search for employment and coach them through their challenges at the workplace. We were delighted when we were announced a winner and got a tremendous vote of confidence from the Microsoft team here, and also received a standing offer from LinkedIn to include the solution on their platform should we decide to go ahead and make it a viable product. The Microsoft team then introduced us to SG Enable, a government-backed disability and accessibility enablement organization. After several meetings and pitching them the solutions, they decided to back the project, and they supported us with a big grant to cover a major part of the product development. Microsoft also extended to us a generous quantum of Azure credits for the development. This is how Empower was born. Empower is now an active company. We are currently working with our partners such as Microsoft. Pratima here is a huge ambassador and a supporter of this initiative and has committed to be an executive mentor to us on behalf of Microsoft. Dr. Ian McDonald, CTO at Microsoft for Startup, has also extended his mentorship to help strengthen the product and be available for technical guidance, as well as Raymond Hoonan of Microsoft UK, who has also very kindly offered his mentoring. We invited other organizations to join us with their contributions either as a potential employers of people with autism or to offer technical or subject matter expert help and get involved. Various philanthropic organizations, including Meta School and Pathlight, have since come forward to get involved and support our project. We have just hired a business leader and technology leaders, data scientists, and the work of the product development has begun. The project is based on Azure and has strongly leveraged Azure's cognitive services and machine learning capabilities. The Azure cognitive services accelerate our technology development with prepackaged modules, a big help. The simple task of participation in the hackathon gave birth to a new idea, which then formed a new startup. This has led to creation of a very exciting solution in the area of employability for people with autism and has the power of good AI that I believe will make a significant impact on the society. This foray into accessibility has now become one of the key differentiators for Zopa. Zopa has also stood for maximizing objectivity in hiring and selection. This initiative takes us beyond gender, race, age, or similar inclusions to create inclusive for neurodiverse talent. We again intend to participate in the hackathon this year, and I encourage others who are passionate about our cause and have ideas to bring them to the hackathon. And like us, they may be able to create a startup for good. It is a rare opportunity to get a platform such as this and to be on the radar of Microsoft. The trajectory that your idea can get is unbelievable. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for that, Nina, my good friend, and thanks a lot for your work with us on this very, very, very critical initiative. I have the extreme honor and huge pleasure to tell you that the UNDP is working closely with us on this hackathon. And we are so fortunate to have Ms. Sitara Syed, who is the UNDP Deputy Resident Representative at Vietnam, joining us on an address on how they see accessibility and how they would like to work with us and with all of you on this initiative. So over to you, Ms. Sitara Syed.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Xin chào các bạn. It is my pleasure to be with you here today at the launch of the Virtual Artificial Intelligence for Accessibility Hackathon. As you know, the 2030 Agenda and its framework of 17 Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs as we call them, were adopted by 193 United Nations member states in September 2015. Governments across the globe have responded, moving from adoption of the goals to their implementation at the national level, at a much faster pace than it was the case with the Millennium Development Goals. Vietnam is among the front-runner countries that have taken steps to integrate the SDGs into existing national development plans, policies, and legislation earlier on. In May 2017, the Prime Minister issued the National Action Plan for implementation of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, with the same 17 SDGs and 115 targets, which include important indicators relating to accessibility and social integration of people with disabilities. One of the most pressing concerns for people with disabilities is accessibility. This issue is not only an inherent right of persons with disabilities, but also a means to empower people with disabilities to exercise all their rights and participate fully in society on equal basis with others. Accessibility is a precondition for an inclusive society, because when it's achieved, people with disabilities will have more opportunities in mobility, accessing services like education, health, employment, and so on. As a result, their independence, confidence, and dignity are enhanced, and people with disabilities can take full part in their communities. Technology, particularly artificial intelligence or AI, plays a key role in assisting our modern life and social development. In the rapid advancement of technology, we need to ensure that it does not widen the gaps among different social groups. It must support the full integration of persons with disabilities into society. And as we move forward, ensure that we leave no one behind. The artificial intelligence, therefore, must offer enabling tools for persons with disabilities, as it does for the rest of us. We know from our experience that there is great potential here. In our 2019 SDG Challenge on Accessibility, we brought forward a number of examples on how artificial intelligence can be applied to support different types of disabilities. For teaching sign language to deaf kids, for assisting people with physical disabilities to operate the computer without using their hands, and for helping parents of children with autism to learn about their behavior and to better understand and take care of them. That is why we are part of this exciting hackathon with Microsoft on accessibility for people with disabilities. According to the 2016 National Survey on Persons with Disabilities, 7.06% of population from 2 years old and over are disabled. This equals to over 6.2 million people, among whom 14% are people with visual impairments. This is a sizable group. We should and must make sure that they are not left behind. Today, we are very pleased to launch this virtual hackathon on artificial intelligence for accessibility with Microsoft Vietnam. We hope this will be one step forward in removing the barriers in their mobility, connectivity, communication, and employment. UNDP and Microsoft together have formulated clear and practical problem statements for the hackathon. And I strongly believe that this competition can identify useful initiatives to enhance the quality of life of people with visual impairments. UNDP highly appreciates Microsoft's proactiveness in designing this hackathon, which perfectly fits the SDGs. We are committed to our shared goals of promoting innovation for the inclusion of hundreds of thousands of people with visual impairments. This hackathon should be a starting point for our future partnership in skills training, inclusive innovation, and equal employment opportunities for persons with disabilities. We sincerely wish you great success in this hackathon, and we're looking forward to seeing the conceptualization and realization of great ideas through this competition. I wish you all great health, success, and lots of happiness. Thank you very much. Xin cảm ơn.
Radima, you're live.
And now I would really like to thank our partner sponsors, the various teams within Microsoft, LinkedIn, Telstra Foundation, and our strategic partners, Datacom, who have been instrumental in getting this out to you. And most importantly, thank you so much to the nonprofit organizations who have worked closely with us and shared their real use cases, their real needs across all the countries that we are taking this hackathon to. Very excited again to tell you that it's coming to you to your country, 11 countries across of APAC. And I would love to encourage everybody here to actually think about how you could lean in with your technology and help innovate and create assistive tech. To help you understand what are the nuances of this specific hackathon, how you could exactly do this, I will now hand over to my colleagues in Datacom who are bringing this hackathon to you. So over to you, Midhu.
Hey, thanks so much, Prathima. And just as Prathima said, look, thank you so much for joining us today. So first off, let's introduce ourselves. So my name's Midhu, and this is Tivi. We're going to be your hack lead. So if you need any help, we're the right people, but we've got a lot more people behind it as well. So just a big shout out to Rahul, Shatej, and Shivangi. And then you've got some months. You'll meet all of these people through the journey. And again, thanks a lot for being on our journey. So let's start off. First off, what are we all competing for? So look, firstly, glory. And I guess it's glory in terms of actually being able to make a difference. And that's certainly what I guess this hackathon is all about. And, you know, if you've been nerdy like I normally am, and you've gone onto the website and you've had a look, there's actually even a prize for glory. So make sure you stand out for that. Alongside that, I guess, you know, there's a lot of prizes. And I guess, you know, when we talk about prizes here, if your idea, the thing you want to do is actually genuinely making an impact, I think Microsoft's actually done an amazing job at being able to back you to make it come to life and out into the community. I mean, there's the Microsoft grant that you actually get help with. And, you know, that's no mean feat. And I think if you look at the winners from last year, that's made a huge difference. You also get to go into the Azure Marketplace. And there's a myriad of other prizes that are there. And each country, you have pride in winning it for your country and taking it forward. Alongside all of that, I guess, you know, the main thing that I'd like to say is it has, you know, there wouldn't be a presentation this year where we wouldn't say it hasn't been tough. But at these times, more so than ever before, this is really our chance to make a difference. And, you know, I applaud all of you guys for being here. And if there are people, you know, that aren't here today, but could make a difference, I'd actually ask you to bring them in. So look, so I think alongside that, it'll probably be good for you guys to actually find out what is it going to take to win. So let me hand it to my partner in crime.
Thank you so much, Midu. Yes, as Midu said, so it's not just about making a difference. It's also how do you win the hackathon. So there's three simple steps. First one, you have to register as a team. So you get onto the website, make sure you register your team. And after that, you can join the community and ask any questions about the hackathon or any of the challenges that's been put out by the NGOs. Make sure you register before the 30th of October at midnight. So post that on the 6th of November, you have to submit the mission canvas. Don't worry if you don't know anything about mission canvas. On the 21st of October, we'll be publishing a training session about how do you create an impactful mission canvas. But if you want to make a head start, you can actually go ahead to bit.ly/mission canvas and download the template and start creating a mission canvas. On the successful of submitting a mission canvas, you will be presenting to a panel of judges remotely, where the presentation will be 7 minutes. You either get to present your proof of concept live, or you can record a video and present it to the judges. The final presentation will be on the 18th of November. We'll be in touch with you in terms of the allocated time slots. Based on that, 2 days from there, we'll be announcing the winners live on the website on the 20th of November. So we'll make sure to send you an invitation for that as well. So just to reiterate in terms of the team formation, as I mentioned before, you get to the website where it's microsoftaccessibility.ai. Once you get to the website, you will see register your team. When you click on the button, you will get to enter your team name and your team members' name as well. Post that, in terms of the rules, you can have minimum of 2 team members and maximum of 5. In terms of the current registration number, so this is where you get, say, over 50 teams have registered across 11 countries. And as you can see, Singapore and Malaysia are well ahead. So make sure to get your friends to register for the competition. So there's a higher chance of your country taking out the challenge this year. Now, in terms of officially starting out a bit of challenge on the community, there's Kayla that's already started the challenge. So let me tease you with a couple of videos.
Introductions to rap, show me where my heart is. Microsoft to data, call set up as prequel. We got problems to solve to make things more equal. You started with your team to build upon your dream, work out your canvas, making sure we're clean. And it means you're using maps to direct your user journey, using your UVP to travel down revenue streams.
That's right. So she put out a challenge to the community, and the challenge was accepted. And guess what? Jun Park took it on. Here it is.
Microsoft APAC, AI for Accessibility, LinkedIn, Datacom, Telstra Foundation. Yo, let's go. This challenge is real, let me tell you the deal, and maybe with this brand, I'll change how you feel. Of the world's by letting people are out of action. 15.
That's right. That's just to tease out a little bit. So you can see all the full video on the community. So make sure that you go check it out. So now Jun Park has actually thrown out the challenge to the rest of Asia. So really looking forward to what you guys bring it to the challenge. All right. So in terms of team formation, don't worry if you don't have a team. You can actually reach out to us in the community and we'll make sure to connect you with other team members. So a few people have already reached out to us and we've successfully connected them to the other teams. In terms of challenges, so as Pratima said, there's over 50 challenges on the website. You can choose any one of them. And today we've actually got two NGOs presenting with us. The very first one is from Retrieve. So let's have a look what they have to say.
Hi, I'm Bev, one of Retrieve's IT instructors and web accessibility auditors. Adaptive technology for rehabilitation, integration, and empowerment of the visually impaired, or Retrieve is a nonprofit organization that empowers blind and visually impaired people by transforming them and their communities through the use of technology. You might not know this, but we, persons with visual impairments, are just like you. We attend remote meetings at work, participate in an online class, watch news for a source of information, watch our favorite movies or TV shows, or sometimes when we want to chill, aimlessly scroll through our social media feeds and share our special moments or important information through graphics. But there are times that these things can be challenging to do, especially when the technology we're using, like screen reader, can't do the trick to make it accessible for us. Because of this, our way of communication is sacrificed. Like you, we want to confidently share our ideas in a meeting, laugh or cry with our friends and family while watching a TV show, appreciate memes and infographics to react better, or perhaps create our own to entertain and inform others. But most importantly, we want to communicate to help in making our society better. A society where inclusion is not just a word, but an action that every one of us practices. We, persons with visual impairment, want to connect, truly connect. And this connection is possible if we could communicate better by making these things accessible.
Great, thank you so much from Team Retrieve. Then there are many more challenges from Retrieve on the website, so make sure to check it out. So the second one we have is from the Vocational Center of Nobi Blind Association, and this is great. This is around how do we make public transport more accessible. So let's check that out.
Thank you.
right. Awesome. So thank you for both the NGOs for putting out the video, and there'll be many videos available in the community as well. Now, alternatively, you may also address your own accessibility challenge as well. A few members have reached out to us in terms of bringing their local nonprofit organizations to the challenge, which is totally fine as well. Now, in terms of training sessions, so over the next month, we'll be running a variety of training sessions. Just to call out a few, Tima will be running the Accessibility 101 in terms of some of the challenges being faced right now, and also what sort of technology is being used to address those challenges. And of course, Midi Chandra is going to be running the Mission Canvas in terms of how do you actually build an impactful Mission Canvas for this particular hackathon. So make sure you watch those training sessions. And of course, AI being the technical platform, I guess, in terms of technical trainings, got a variety of trainings, and just to call out a few, Power Platform will be one of them, where you get to build AI solutions or mobile solutions using no code at all. So this will be a key tool, so make sure you attend this training session as well. So I'll hand it over to Midu in terms of talking about judging criteria.
All right, look, thanks a lot, Tivi. Look, there's I know there's a lot of information to take in. A good thing is that it's being recorded, so you can always come back. And if we haven't said it enough times, if you've got any questions, just reach out on the community. So we've tried to, as clearly as possible, just articulate what the judging criteria is, but I'll just go and spell out a few things. I guess the first criteria that we'll be applying to all the entries that are coming through, and I wish you all the best, and hopefully all of you will be winners, which you will. So specificity, and really what we're looking at is, first and foremost, I guess the NGOs have put in a lot of time in terms of putting out some of these challenges that we can actually address with technology. So we'll be looking for, has it addressed the challenge that they've actually shared with us, hence the name specificity. Obviously, you know, as you have questions, get on the community and we can actually get the NGOs to come and explain the problem a little bit further if that's what's required. Alongside that, I guess, you know, the next criterion is innovation, and that can be quite a big or ethereal sort of term. But here, when we're talking about innovation, what we're really looking for is, has your idea, your concept, your program actually charted new ground? Is it really making that impact? So that's what we're looking for. Scalability, I guess that's the third criterion, which is, we've specifically hit the challenge that's been addressed. We've provided innovation. Now, if this was something that was actually going across APAC and then hopefully, you know, across the globe, has the thinking been put in place where that can happen? We realize in the scale of the hackathon, you might not have the most scalable thing, but as long as the thinking and the concepts are there, that's something that's really, really important. For all the CXers and designers and creative people, we're really looking for the user centricity behind your idea, right? And this is where we're really looking for some validation that you have done with people to go, this is truly addressing a need or a job to be done, and it is actually making a difference, it is inclusive. And then I guess, you know, as the hackathon theme itself says, we're looking for something which embraces the potential that AI brings, be that in conversational AI, vision AI, predictive. We're really looking for, how can you harness the potential that AI actually has to, I guess, enhance what humans are able to do to this. So look, so with that, what I'd just like to say is, and you'd all be very, very aware of this, but at the end of the day, a lot of this is being shared in good faith. And what we'd like you to do is, as you're having those conversations with our NGOs, we'd like you to keep the things that I guess you would, you know, deemed to be confidential. And if you ever you have any questions, please ask us on the community, and we're more than happy to help you with that. If you need any help, I've said it again, and I'll say it again, just ask on the community and we'll be there. There's the URL, but you can access it from the main website as well. Look, so in closing, with all of that, what I'd just like to say is, firstly, thank you so much for all of you for making the time. I guess it's good morning for some of you, good afternoon, and good evening. So thanks so much for making the time. Thanks so much for actually caring to make a difference. And we're immensely, you know, determined to see what amazing things you can all bring. So look, go well. and keep safe, and you know, let the challenge begin, and we'll be working with you in the next couple of weeks. Thanks a lot. Cheers.